What's up, my add-ons? Advantageous here, and I'm bringing you some Battle Spot Doubles. Bringing back Zygarde. And look at that. We find someone in no time at all. So I'm obviously playing with special Pokemon allowed, so that's why we're seeing Solgaleo. But three of his mons don't have items. Which is weird. I don't know why that happens. It should be like a requirement. You know, it's like you can't have duplicate items. Like your mon doesn't have an item. Okay. So Zygarde puts in a ton of work. The only problem I see is that Regice. So I'm bringing Infernape for that. I think I'm going to lead Infernape Metagross. Just to make sure I can get rid of that Regice. Because once it goes, it just puts in the work. Sylveon doesn't look too good here. Persian. Persian doesn't look bad. I think I'll bring Persian. Because, Mantike. I guess I could take care of that Dazzling Gleam, but it just gets, like, rocked by Thunderbolt. Yeah, it doesn't do very well, so I'll bring the Persian in the back. So, good luck to my opponent. See if Zygarde can pull this off. So my biggest concern is the Regice. I'm not really concerned about anything else. So as soon as I get rid of that, I think I should be okay. Question mark? Exclamation point. All right, he brings it out. Beautiful. All right, so I'm guessing there's going to be a Blizzard coming out. I'm going to fake out the Solgaleo as I Meteor Mash this Regice. Is that the right play? Yeah, I think it's the right play. Pretty standard opening. Well, I mean, Fake Out's pretty obvious, but... I didn't want to go with Mega Metagross. I wanted to be able to have it take a few more hits, especially. But Mega Metagross is, like, it's so OP. And you know, you guys know me, I don't like using OP stuff. I like using fun stuff. I just came back from bowling, and I've been bowling since I was 2 years old, and I didn't do that well, and it was very disappointing, you know, because I'm such a tryhard, because I've been playing it for so long, you know, I've gone to tournaments. Oh, is that Focus Sash? Wow. All right, I'm going to take nothing. Don't get the freeze. Don't you dare. All right, so I'm going to overheat Solgaleo. There's almost no reason for me to go for Bullet Punch. What do you have in the back? I'm just wondering if he's gonna switch out. He could go into Gyarados. But I mean, like, yeah, I'm gonna go. Do I want to risk the Zen Headbutt miss? No, I think I'm just gonna Meter Mash that slot. Just go for the he's in a tough spot. Yeah, he doesn't even switch, so. Maybe I'll get the attack raise too. I guess I should have considered that. Oh, I was expecting it to go down. Sunseal Strike? Do you not have a psychic move for my Infernape? This is such a cool move. And Metagross. Okay. That was a crit. Alright. So Regice goes down, so Zygarde is in a very good position right now. I like this. Yeah, he's really targeting down the Metagross. That's weird. Like, there's a fire type right there. But another overheat should take it out. I mean, I could go for close combat because my defenses don't really matter at this point. Because I am sashed. Infernape's so cool. I love Infernape. Alright, so he's got Magnezone. Okay, so yeah, I'm definitely going to go for close combat here on Magnezone. And then I do believe Meteor Mash is my best play on Solgaleo. Even though it's going to outspeed, I'm not too concerned. As long as it's not like Scarf Magnezone, I should be fine. And, yeah, hopefully this Magnezone isn't sturdy. I can't see his time. He's taking his time, so... But time shouldn't be a factor. Because at this point... Yeah, at this point it's not looking good for him. He just didn't have the type matchup. It might be Magnet for Magnezone. So I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt. Like, he's taken a while, but I think he's just trying to make his play. Yeah, he's sturdy. That's what I thought. Okay, so Sunsteel Strike again. Who's this hitting? Metagross again. He really doesn't like this guy. Like, he really does not like Metagross. Why? What do you got against Metagross? What do you got against Steel Crabs? Zap Cannon. Maybe if you were running like a gravity team? Because I mean, like, that would really work. Regice Magnezone? Go like, go Specs Zap Cannon with gravity? Because I think Regice gets gravity. Regice, like, yeah. Or yeah, do like Choice Scarfed Magnezone? But no, if you're running Zap Cannon, you're just gonna be paralyzing everything. Alright, okay, so now I can't give him the benefit of the doubt anymore. But I mean, like, this is free battle. Just play. Alright, Decidueye comes out. Going to overheat, Decidueye slot, and Rock Slide. Too bad I didn't get any boosts this turn. Oh well. I don't know if this Decidueye is going to be fast. I guess we'll see. But I think I've pretty much got this wrapped up. Zygarde's in the back. There's no way it loses to a Decidueye. Not in the slightest. But yeah, so back to my bowling. Yeah. Yeah, I get very try-hard with bowling. Just because I feel like I should be so good at it. And... that's where it kind of comes, like, Pokemon really comes into play, where I realize that I don't want to be like that. You know, I don't want to play where the point is, like, I have to win every time, or it's just not worth it. So, that's why I like just picking ones that are fun. Spirit Shackle on Metagross? Can I live that? Nope. Well, he finally took it down after he targeted it so much. Oh! What is that? That was... is that steel? Corkscrew Crash? I mean, like, if you ran... no, because it doesn't affect Zap Cannon. You can still miss. So yeah, so this should take me down. Oh, it doesn't even take me down to Sash. That's sad. Let's bring out Zygarde. Just for the fun of it. You know what? I'm gonna go Pro Blaze and switch Infernape out. And I'm gonna go for that 1,000 waves. Yeah, that's a fast Decidueye. But I mean, look, it's got decent speed. I have, like, no speed investment in my Metagross. Here comes Persian. 1,000 waves. This move looks cool. Yeah, it doesn't, I wasn't expecting it to take Decidueye out. I probably could have gone for, oh, he can no longer escape! Oh no! Is he targeting Zygarde? Okay. That did... that... wow, another crit. See? Where are my crits? I want to count, like, I should look back at my videos. How many crits have gone against me? So let's foul play, substitute. Well, he actually made, picked up his speed. I appreciate that. And yeah, there's no way he was living that. Oh, there's a crit! There it is! There it is, guys! Okay, so that match took way too long. I don't think my opponent was being very salty, but I will see you guys in the next one. Alright, and here we go with our next opponent. That will focus at some point. Sabas G. Oh, he's actually got a pretty scary team. But he picked his team really fast, so no, I don't think Mudsdale's coming. Do I have anything for that Garchomp? I have Sylveon. I'm kind of liking Persian Sylveon lead. I don't really see where his answer for that is. So I'm gonna lead Persian Sylveon. I don't particularly like Infernape in this one. Not really crazy about Metagross either. But I'll have Zygarde in the back. And I guess I'll bring Infernape. Just because it's good support. I could bring Mantyke. I'll bring Infernape. Sounds good. I am Light Orb Sylveon, if you guys remember, instead of Specs. Just a little bit different. I usually like to run Specs on my Sylveon. But this Life Orb Hyper Voice is going to be devastating. Alright, so good luck to my opponent. I'm bringing my two cats. Garchomp, Mudsdale. He did bring the Mudsdale. Interesting. Mudsdale is very much a threat. I'm going to fake out Garchomp. And I'm going to Hyper Voice. So we might see Protect from Garchomp here. And this Sylveon is my Auras Sylveon. That's why it can have Hyper Voice, because it's a tutor move. And it was the one that I bred this one with HP Fire. So if that thing comes in, whatever it's called, I might get Heavy Slammed. Sylveon might get Heavy Slammed here, which would not be good. Don't think it's going to take that very well. So I don't know if the connections are just bad. What's going on? I don't know. I got a party coming up soon. I got a little bit of time to myself. Oh, that was a crit. There we go. I got another crit. Hyper Voice comes through. This is going to hurt. Garchomp goes down. Alright, so as long as this Mudsdale doesn't Heavy Slam me, I should be okay. Life Orb. Earthquake. Okay, I can take that. No problem. Yeah, that doesn't even do half. Persian's bulky. Got defense for days. So Galio comes out. So I think half. I think I'm gonna foul play with Solgaleo. And Hyper Voice again. Because I can get some big damage off. Like, I could HP Fire the Solgaleo, but it's not gonna do that much. Mudsdale does protect, but that's fine. Hopefully, this Hyper Voice plus foul play can come through. Oh, wow, look at that. That does a ton. There we go. I didn't even think I was going to outspeed. I should have protected. That would have been the smart play, but yeah, Sylveon's not living this. But that's okay. And then what did I bring? Brought Zygarde. I think it's time. Because I don't really see what he can do to me. So I think what I want to do, I'm going to be a little cheeky here. I'm going to Parting Shot the Mudsdale. And just Protect with Zygarde. So it's going to be a little cheeky play to get Infernape in here for free. Unless he goes for that Earthquake. But I mean, like, this is why I'm, you know, doing the this move on him. So that way he can't pull that crap on me. Fernape. Yeah, we could see. Oh yeah, we didn't even see. Oh, he goes for Earthquake. I don't think I can live double Earthquake. Fernape is not very bulky. Yeah, see, even that does a lot. So Earthquake, is he running like a full Earthquake team? Yeah, he is. He's gotta be. Like, he's just like doing that to get his Mudsdale thing up. But this will probably kill the Solgaleo. Nope. Okay, so Cheeky Play didn't work. Let's bring this in. But I should definitely be able to double Earthquake, or like Earthquake here. Alright, so let's foul play the Mudsdale. And 1,000 Waves. We might see. Oh, it's Quick Claw. Interesting. Fake out on Mudsdale. That's okay. Can get the boost all at once. I have... what do you call it? I have a special move, so I'm okay. And I have foul play. So I'm not worried about this Mudsdale, even though it is a pretty big threat. Wow, I just lived! Fur coat. Okay. So that takes care of that. Oh no, Mudsdale can no longer escape, but he's only got one Pokemon left! Oh no! Whatever shall we do? Lunala! Yeah, I'm definitely foul playing you. Cord Forcer. But yeah, even if like they survive this, Zygarde can take a hit, get the cord for get the boost. Yeah, even with its ability, like that does a lot. Will-O-Wisp on who? Okay, on Zygarde, that's fine. Cord Forcer, because I have a special move. Yay me! So this seems to be like a sort of Mudsdale strategy. It seems. I think it wasn't like Figgy Berry or something. That would have been very bad. Oh, wow. Yeah, Corn Forcer. Yeah, imagine. Well, it wouldn't have mattered. It would have suppressed its ability anyways. Alright. And Foul Play will do the trick. Plus Corn Forcer. That will end this game. Lunala, no ability. The Zygarde's just kind of there. Just being a tank. Being a beast. Love and light. So yeah, I think I got time for another one. So. Okay, the win. So I'll meet you guys in the next one. And here's our final opponent. Blur, blur, blur. It's Mate Blaz. Man, what's with these Mons not having items? I really like Mantyke here. Because I see a lot of potential stuff that can be wide guard protected. Let's see here. As for when bringing Sylveon, does good against everything except the Lucario. So I bring Infernape for that. So I think I want to bring Mantyke Infernape. Persian does decent, again, but yeah, I'm relying on Infernape to take out that Lucario. Did I bring Sylveon Zygarde? I think so. Yeah, Sylveon Zygarde is pretty good. Leaving my tanks in the back. Because yeah, one thing, I don't like Milotic. I can beat it 1v1, but... I think especially with Zygarde. because like I'm just a tank. Tanky Zygarde is tanky. Metagross Lucario, that's not bad. I can deal with that. Let's go for I want to go for, you know what? I'm going to go for an interesting play here. I'm going to go for Haze as I overheat this Lucario. I think that's a good play, because that'll get rid of my my negative. But I'm definitely scared of this Lucario. It's very scary against my team. Oh, it's Mega Metagross. Okay, I think I picked the wrong target. And that might be like Inner Focus Lucario. Yeah, I definitely picked the wrong target. Overheat. Don't be sashed, please. Okay, thank you. Zen Headbutt doesn't miss. Okay, so I'm thinking, alright, so what is he going to bring in here? He's definitely got Bullet Punch on this thing, no question. Question is, what can I do about it? Oh, he brings in this thing. I don't like that. So let's go for Tailwind as I switch Infernape into Zygarde. I would like to bring Sylveon in, but yeah, that's just not a smart switch when I know he's going for the Bullet Punch this turn. Worst case, he does actually go for predict this and switch out, and Zen Headbutts me. No, Earthquakes. I would have. No, I don't think I outspeed him. That's fine with me. He uses Toxic against that. That's fine. Do I outspeed this thing? Because I need to go for sub this turn. Oh yeah, I'll definitely outspeed it with a Tailwind. I don't think I'll outspeed this Metagross. And I can definitely Wide Guard this turn to protect against the Earthquake. Alright, Wide Guard. Let's go for sub. That is a very good play on my part. I like Mantic. I love using it as a... It's very niche, but it works. And, like, I don't see what he can do against me. And if he goes for Icy Wind this turn, like, there's nothing he can really do. He goes for Zen Headbutt on the Mantic. Really? Scared of that thing. Ice Beam? Okay, so that was not a productive turn. Not in the slightest. So I definitely need to Helping Hand. I don't think Zygarde can live this Ice Beam. Let's go for 1,000 Waves. I think I have one more turn of Tailwind after this. This is going to be interesting. It really does depend. Can I live this Ice Beam? If I can't, I think I just lose. Here it comes. Can I live this? Yeah, I think I lose. I've got Infernape, so it's not the worst. I forgot I switched him out. Okay, so this isn't the worst, because a Life Orb Hyper Voice will definitely do enough. And I think if he had the Bullet Punch, he would have gone for it. So let's go for Hyper Voice. And... You know what, I am just going to fake out the Metagross, even though, yeah, I think that's my play. Yeah, I thought I only had Sylveon left. It's good for me. All right, Hyper Voice. Come on, take it. I need you to take out the Milotic, 100%. Oh, that did not do enough to the Metagross. What was that? Something fell. Whew. Yeah, Tailwind's gone. Like, he might be Earthquaking here. So I can at least get, like, a little bit of damage off before Infernape goes down. Buzzwole! Well, you go down. I'm not scared of you. You don't get poisoned yet, do you? I don't think you do. I think I'm just gonna overheat on the Metagross. I'm banking on him not having Bullet Punch. He hasn't shown it all game. If he does, he got me good. Basically. Oh, I don't even outspeed. Yes, I do. Okay. Oh, I almost blew that. Woo! So yeah, there's no way I lose this now. That was way closer than I needed it to be. Fault. I would have laughed if he hit my Infernape. That would have just been, like, absolutely hilarious. Bye, Buzzwole. You're not Assault Vest, so get up out of here. So that is going to do it for this episode. Gonna wait till we get a defeated Mate Blast. So that's 3 wins. This team is undefeated, guys. Like, I am just a powerhouse. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye!